So next endocrine gland is parathyroid gland. Parathyroid glands. Okay. So parathyroid glands. So parathyroid glands are located on the. They are located on the thyroid gland. Thyroid gland. So already we have studied the thyroid gland is the butterfly shaped structure or bilobed structure. So on the lobes, each lobe two small globular structures are present which are called parathyroid glands. So these are called parathyroid glands. So four glands are present. So four small glands are present. Glands are present on the thyroid gland. So in each lobe, two glands are present. Okay. So this is about location. Next, parathyroid gland secretes the parathormone. Parathormone or parathyroid hormone. Parathyroid hormone. So parathyroid gland secretes a parathormone or parathyroid hormone. So next we will discuss about function. So next coming to the function of parathyroid gland, parathyroid hormone. So mainly this hormone increases the calcium levels in blood. Okay, it increases the calcium levels. So that's why this is called hypercalcemic hormone. So because of it increases the calcium levels in blood. So that's why this hormone is called hypercalcemic hormone. So how it is increases the calcium levels in our body? Mainly it promotes the regulates the calcium absorption from intestine. It stimulates the calcium absorption from the intestine. So more calcium is added to the blood. Next, stimulates the osteoclast in bone. So osteoclast means these are one type of cells which are present in the bone. So this hormone stimulates the osteoclast. So as a result, these osteoclast promotes the demineralization in bone. The demineralization processes takes place by the osteoclast. So that's why the calcium and phosphorus ions releases into the blood. So calcium and phosphorus ions are released into the blood. So whenever in our blood the calcium ions are decreased, calcium levels are decreased, this hormone secreted into the blood. So as a result, this hormone stimulates the calcium absorption from the intestine. Next function, stimulates the osteoclast. So these osteoclasts, they promotes the demineralization process. So in the demineralization process, the calcium and phosphorus ions, they releases into the blood from the bone. They release into the blood from the bone. Okay, so in the bone, the calcium ions are stored in the bone. So that stored calcium ions are releases into the blood. Next one more, the calcium reabsorption stimulates the calcium reabsorption from renal tubule. So in this process, this hormone increases the calcium levels. So that's why here the parathyroid gland increases the calcium ions. The parathyroid hormone is increases the calcium ions. The calcitonin hormone is secreted from thyroid gland. That hormone decreases the calcium ions. So both works antagonistic nature. So both hormone to the both hormones, the calcitonin hormone and parathyroid hormone, both they maintains the calcium levels in our body. Okay, so this is about the parathyroid gland. Okay, next, coming to the next gland is pineal gland. Pineal gland. Next endocrine gland is pineal gland. This pineal gland is located dorsal surface of the diencephalon means it's a region of brain. Okay, so in the diencephalon, the dorsal surface of the diencephalon, a small rounded lobe like structure is present. So that is pineal gland. Next, pineal gland secretes melatonin hormone. It secretes the melatonin hormone. Next, we will discuss about the functions of melatonin hormone. Okay, so melatonin hormone mainly in the human being, mainly melatonin hormone regulates the or stimulates the 24-hour rhythms. So it stimulates or regulates the 24-hour rhythms or circadian and diurnal rhythms. So for example, sleep wake cycles. Okay, so these regular rhythmic process are regulated by the melatonin hormone. So next, along with this hormone is also regulates the metabolism. Next, pigmentation regulates the pigmentation. Next, regulates the menstrual cycle. So these rhythmic process, okay, so all rhythmic process are controlled by the melatonin hormone. Okay, mainly it controls the or regulates the 24-hour rhythmic process. Okay, like circadian or diurnal rhythms, like sleep wake cycles. Okay, next, also regulates the metabolism. Next, pigmentation also. Next, menstrual cycle in females. Okay, so this is about pineal gland. So pineal gland secretes the melatonin hormone. Okay, next endocrine gland is thymus gland. Okay, so the thymus gland is located chest region or above the heart. It's just located above the heart or beneath the chest bone. Okay, above the heart or beneath the chest bone, a small lobe like structure is present, that is thymus gland. So thymus gland secretes the thymosin hormone. It secretes thymosin hormone. So this thymosin hormone provide the immunity. It helps in the immunity power. It play important role in the providing of the immunity. Okay, so this thymosin hormone mainly it helps in the differentiation of lymphocytes. So in the immunity process. Next, it also helps in the production of antibodies. Production of antibodies. So mainly the hormone. So this thymosin hormone is helps in the immunity power. It helps in the production of immunity. Okay. So this is about thymosin hormone. Next here, thyroid gland has a one special feature, that is, so normally at the birth it has smaller in size. At the age of birth, it has smaller in size. Slowly, in kids, slowly, according to the age, the size is increased. Okay, so it is, for example, it is kids. So slowly the size is increased. So whenever the kids reach to the puberty, it reached to the maximum size. It reached to the maximum size. Then after that, slowly the size of this gland is decreasing. Okay, so in adult the size again decreased. Next, when it reached to the in older age, okay, so the size is reached to the at the birth stage. So that's why in old people the immunity power is decreased, because the decreasing of the size of the thymus gland. Okay, normally at the age of birth and in older people the size is same. At the age of birth it has smaller in size, slowly the size is increased. Next, at the persons when they reach to puberty, it's reached to the maximum size. Next, after that, slowly again the size is decreased. The degeneration takes place. So in older people, the size is decreased when it reached to the birth stage. That size is reached to the how much size is there? It reached to the same size. So that's why in older people, the immunity power is less because of the degeneration of this hormone. Okay, so this is about thymus gland. So mainly thymus gland provide the immunity.